Hello and welcome to the PolyKit YouTube channel. Today I would like to talk about the analog polyphonic synthesizer I've built over the last year. If you haven't seen the demonstration video already, I'm going to link it in the description below. First I'm going to talk about the motivation and some design rules I agreed on. After that I will talk about basic synthesizers and polyphony. Then there's a quick rundown on how I designed the PCBs in KiCad and a technical overview of the components. At the end of the video, there will be some conclusion on the build and an outlook of upcoming videos. I mean, obviously, polyphonic synthesizers sound awesome. I started building a modular synthesizer in a pandemic and it's monophonic. It sounds great, but be able to play chords or have long release times on different voices is just another thing. I also started wondering why there are so few polysynth builds out there. Also, there's not much information on this topic in the DIY scene, so I decided to build one. I agreed on the following loose design rules. It should be as simple as possible. It should be as inexpensive as possible. Schematics and PCB layouts should be publicly available afterwards. Use only discrete circuits, meaning off-the-shelf components like op-amps, transistors, capacitors, and so on. I broke that rule, but I will talk about that later on. Every function should have a distinct module, so it could be easily replaced. I use 60-pin IDC connectors for all incoming and outgoing signals on the modules. Modules are powered by Eurorack-style power supply. That brings the benefit that modules can be reused somewhere else, for example in a modular synthesizer. After finishing the first module, it became obvious how much I underestimated the work this is going to be and why there are so few DIY polysynths out there. A basic synthesizer has an oscillator, a filter, a VCA, and an envelope generator. I won't go much into the details here. If you don't know what a VCO, VCF, or ADSR is, then please check the description below. I will put a few videos on those topics in there. We have an oscillator that creates our signal, and its frequency is controlled from outside. The control can be a keyboard, a sequencer, or something else changing the pitch of the oscillator. It also triggers the ADSR, which shapes the sound over time in the VCA. The signal is also going through a VCF, which is adding even more characteristics to the sound. A polyphonic synthesizer is just the same, but you have this setup as many times as voices your synthesizer has. Now there are a few problems. You have many output signals, and also control of the oscillators and ADSRs become a bit more difficult. The output part is easy, you just add a mixer to sum up all the signals. Control of the voices is a bit harder. You need some kind of logic, which is assigning a new note that is played to a certain voice. You don't want to reassign a voice that is currently playing, but you also need to override the voice if there are more notes played at the same time than voices available. This is usually handled by a microcontroller. In addition, all parameters need to be voltage controllable, so they can be changed on all voices at the same time. There also needs to be a solution to switch between signal paths, for example between different wave shapes of the oscillators. Usually I start by breadboarding the circuit for a single voice. When I confirm that it's working, I create the schematic in KiCad in a separate sheet, which can be multiplied afterwards. There are labels which export certain signals to the main sheet. Now the layout for one voice can be done. When this is finished, the layout can be copied to the other voices with the Replicate Layout plugin. All voices can now be aligned on the board. I had good results by putting the odd voices on one side of the board and the even ones on the opposite side. After this, input, output, and power lines can be connected. This was quite hard at first because I had to use many wires to switch between top and bottom layers. Over time I got more experienced and layout went much smoother. The circuit of the DCO is loosely based on the Roland Juno 106. I used a Raspberry Pi Pico to control the voices and handle MIDI input. It has programmable I/O pins that are highly accurate for frequency control. Three I/O pins are needed per voice, one for frequency control, one for amplitude compensation, and one for the gate signal when a note is played. It has six voices, USB and serial MIDI input, MIDI pitch bend. It outputs ramp and square signal. It has PWM control. It allows voice stacking and detuning. The filter is based on the AS3350 state variable filter. This is a clone of a filter I see produced by Curtis in the 80s. Frequency and resonance is voltage controllable and can be tied together to control all voices at the same time. The configuration I used offers low-pass and bandpass output and is based on the datasheet design. In my build, the frequency can be controlled manually by an envelope generator and LFO. Resonance can be controlled manually and by LFO. In the beginning, I mentioned that I wanted to use only discrete circuits, and I broke that rule here. I built a diode ladder filter, but it couldn't be used because all voices sounded different and I also had problems with voltage control of the parameters. Tolerances of the components were too big, and that's why I switched to integrated circuit designs for filter and envelope generator. The build has two separate ADSRs which control filter and VCA. The design is based on the AS3310, also a clone of a Curtis chip which is widely used in synthesizers. All parameters are voltage controllable and can be tied together to have the same envelope on all voices. I took a design from a vintage Kruma polysynth for parameter control. The VCA is based on a discrete design by Yves Husson. It is a differential pair made out of two matched transistors with the current sink. I just multiplied it on one PCB. The LFO outputs triangle and pulse signal. Frequency ranges from very low to almost audible and can control filter frequency and resonance and PWM. The chorus is the only module that I didn't design by myself. I used the Glee Juno 60 chorus clone. It sounds really great. Only disadvantage is that some parts are hard to source and are rather expensive. Additional components that are needed are several multiplexers to switch between signals, a mixer to sum up all the voices, and an inverter for the frequency voltage control of the filter. For the case, I bought some boards in the local hardware store. The front panel is a PCB, which I also designed on KiCad. For the labels and drawings, I left out the solder mask, so solder maintained on the copper layer during the finishing process. As I said before, the whole design and build process was much harder than I thought. Everything is needed six times, and the mass of needed components, layouts, and soldering was a challenge in itself. I also had to redo some of the layouts because of mentioned issues. I needed to make compromises to finish the build at all. But in the end, I'm very happy with the result. I now have a polyphonic synthesizer that can be easily repaired and extended and is programmable. And of course, it sounds great. All the schematics and layouts can be found on my GitHub site linked below. If you're interested in upcoming videos where I take a closer look on the different modules, please subscribe to the channel and hit the like button. Okay, that's it. Thanks for watching and bye for now. What